It is the brightest spot on the Aussie calendar. Yes, Vivid Sydney is back. And today we were given an exclusive look at some of this year's star attractions and new ways of enjoying the Light Festival when the lights turn on in 1 week.
On a grey old day, it's giving Sydney its glow back. Vivid 22 is almost here.
All of the artists from Australia and around the world have been working in lockdown for 2.5 years, and I think we're all really excited to show you what we've been working on for so long.
Zara's bubbles of joy have popped up bigger and better.
We've got just over 100 bubbles here in Walsh Bay, of all different sizes. The biggest are as big as a bus and the smallest are just 1 metre tall.
It's officially lights on next Friday, but we can reveal for the first time the Vivid vibe is going underwater as others get in on the glow fest.
We have the best glowers in the business. They are phosphorescing in the dark and they have come out so spectacularly for Vivid this year.
At Wildlife Sydney Zoo, they've flipped the day-night cycle.
So Leia's going to be very excited to see people. In here we've got our lights reversed, so guests can actually come and see our nocturnal animals that you wouldn't usually see out in the wild.
There is so much to see this year. The Vivid Light Walk has been extended by 2 kilometres. It now runs for 8 kilometres from Circular Quay all the way around to Central Station.
I think what we like most is seeing adults and children react in the same way to it. It is something that everyone really can engage with.
And after the engagement comes the wedding. Today, these newlyweds getting some extra special bubbles of happiness. Ali Donaldson for 10 News First.